In education matters, as school districts here in the Mid-South remain closed during the coronavirus outbreak, parents and students are faced with some big new challenges doing school at home. The good news is you can do it, and there is a lot of help out there online. Germantown resident Stacy Loftis has been a homeschooling mom for almost 2 decades, and she joins us live this morning from her home. Stacy, thank you so much for giving us some time this morning. You have, I know, a daughter in college whom you homeschooled, and you've homeschooled your 6 children off and on. So how many years have you homeschooled, actually?
Well, we're actually in year 19 or 20, I think, or more like year 20, because I started teaching Mary Catherine when she was about 3, just because I was so excited and I couldn't wait to teach her something. poor Mary Catherine. But yeah, so it's been a long time.
Okay.
And by the way, it's great to, even though I can't see you, it's great to invite you into the Loftis house.
Well, thank you for doing so. You have children ranging from all ages. First of all, help parents with their own mindset, because quite honestly, I'm terrified, and I have a very self-directed teenager, but I'm terrified. I don't know what to do because I'm not a teacher. So help parents with that first.
Yeah, well, first I'd like to share that this circumstance, some people are calling it homeschooling, but it's really not. A blogger recently, my sister shared with me an article by a blogger that mentioned that what we're doing now is crisis schooling, because it's not normal for anyone to stay at home all the time. It's not normal for anyone to not get to go play basketball or volleyball with friends or go to their music lessons. And so these are different days for all of us. But I think all parents just need to take a deep breath. You need to know that you are your child's first teacher, and you're actually your child's best teacher and your child's best advocate, and that you're not going to ruin the course of their education by working with them for these next 4 to 6 weeks. I think it's also helpful to remember a time frame, that that this time frame has a limit. You're not going to be teaching them or guiding their education for the next year or two. They've got 4 to 6 weeks, maybe 7 for most school systems, and so it's not going to go on indefinitely. And so I would encourage parents to view this time as a time of educational enrichment. Some schools have laid out their way forward through the online classes, and that's happening in a variety of ways. So depending on the resources that are available to you, that will kind of determine what path you take. For someone who has resources that might be limited, you know, we don't have access to libraries right now, I would encourage them to focus on life skills during these next 4 to 6 weeks.
Okay.
I'm
sorry, Stacy, I'm going to interrupt you. We're putting on the screen right now some of your suggestions for some online. We're going to leave that up. Well, what we noticed video-wise, you have your children separated. They are dressed for work. How important is it to keep them on a schedule? Is that the very first thing that parents should do?
I think it's definitely very helpful. You know, our first week out, we were on spring break, so we did sleep in, we did binge watch the TV series and did all the things. But now that we're 3 weeks in, it is time to have some new normal, time to get in a schedule and a routine. It makes everybody feel better, actually. And now this one, he doesn't have his assigned work yet, so he's scrolling on his phone. But also it's important to build time in for rest each day, especially mamas with toddlers and small children. That hour in the afternoon, or more if you can get it, is really, really important, because none of us are used to being together 24/7. That's just not typical, and we do need breaks from one another. But yeah, the schedule is important. You might have a set time for everybody to work on math each day, or set time for everybody to drop everything and read each day. Time for music, time to watch something on TV that everybody wants to watch. But just structure is great to keep things going, and really gives our kids a sense of safety and comfort as well.
All right, we are going to link to those resources you sent us as well. Thank you so much for that. Number one, you've done the most important thing.
You've calmed us down.
We'll check back in. Homeschooling mom Stacy Loftis, six children over 20 years, so you know she knows what she's talking about.